Time for something about the Samnites. The Samnites were from a region called Samnium, and this was hilly and mountainous. It was largely the central southern part of Italy. I like the fact they've got Mount Vesuvius marked on the map, because in 2015 they found the grave of a Samnite woman aged between 35 and 40 years of age at Pompeii, because the Samnites also got involved elsewhere, and in fact at Pompeii they were in charge for a while, much before Rome ever came near. In terms of language, they spoke Oscan, or a variant of it, and this was a popular language in south central Italy. Here's a bit more closer up, and I have to say it's a beautiful looking language. These are Samnite warriors, depicted on a tomb frieze in Nola, dating from around the 4th century BCE. By the middle of the 4th century BCE, Rome started to expand, and invariably there was conflict with the Samnites. And this started with one war, then there was a second war, and finally a third war. But Rome learnt a lot about itself through those wars, and in fact, it's got a fair amount of thanking to do to the Samnites, though I didn't think they'd do that at the time. In the second Samnite war, Rome was beaten at the Caudine Forks, and this resulted in humiliation. The Roman soldiers forced to march and bend under the yoke, which was created by two spears and a horizontal spear. But they went away and they did what Rome does when it gets beaten. They learn, and they changed part of their military setup. They started to use a sort of maniple-based system, which was smaller units of men which could move around quicker and more freely. And this brought about success. By 290 BCE, the last of the three wars was over and Rome was victorious. But Samnium and the Samnites were always there for a bit of a dust-up if it came about. When Carthage invaded in the Second Punic War, they allied with Hannibal, and when the social war happened, which sounds a bit sort of a contradiction, again, they sided against Rome. The influence of the Samnite military didn't just stop there. They also influenced the culture of Rome, because the Samnites were the earliest form of gladiators at Rome. The Samnites, pretty influential therefore, both on and off the battlefield.